Hey there, what's up everybody? This is your nutritionist on the go, Kamaldeep Singh Aujla from Hero Diet Nutrition. This is the third video in our COVID-19 and diet protocols. Then in this video, we are going to discuss about the supplements that we are going to take. I hope that you have watched the previous two videos of this playlist, the one in which I have described the pathophysiology of COVID-19 and how it harms us. In the second, I have described all the diet protocols, the symptoms and the diets that we have to avoid, the food that we have to avoid and food we have to eat. I hope the video information is reaching up to you and helping you in the way I have intended. Stay tuned and let's start the next video. When it comes to supplementation, the best way to supplement your body with vitamins, minerals, and other micronutrients is to have natural food compounds. But sometimes natural food compounds are not enough, and we have to supplement our diet along with a healthy diet. We have to supplement it in some way. So when it comes to supplementation for a COVID patient, it is one of the necessary factors and a key for faster recovery. So first of all, I would like to recommend omega-3. Omega-3 capsules can be in form of a fish oil capsule or flaxseed oil capsule, depending upon your dietary preferences. In natural sources, you can get omega-3 from nuts and seeds like almonds, walnuts, chia seed, flaxseed, pumpkin seed, sunflower seed. A good amount of omega-3 from fish. So these are very important. If you have good access, do include these in your diet. Even if you do include them in your diet, I would like to suggest that you top up with supplementation of omega-3 so that this omega-3 decreases the inflammatory response, that is the CRP and the interleukin-6 in your body, so that we can have a faster recovery. The inflammatory response of our body has to be suppressed so that we can recover well from the infection. The next most important is vitamin D. Vitamin D is very tricky and it is hard to complete your vitamin D from food sources. So we usually have to sit in sunlight. We usually don't sit in sunlight though. But 30 to 45 minutes of sun in the early morning and same time of sun in the late evening is very beneficial for COVID patients. So even if you are in your home isolation, try to manage a small space of sunlight where other people might not come, your other family members might not come. Have some time in sun. It is drastically going to improve the condition of your body. Vitamin D is very essential for your lung recovery. So either you can have good amount of sunlight, and I would again do have the sunlight, but do top up your day, top up your body with 60,000 international units of vitamin D every fourth day for 1 month. If you want to continue it after that, you can have 60,000 units per week. But for starting, I would recommend having 60,000 units in powdered, liquid or capsule form for 1 month every fourth. So the next vitamin that is very important in COVID, the vitamin that we all know is vitamin C, bringing you back to the controversy that we talked about in the last video. Whenever the name of vitamin C comes, a picture of a lemon, an orange, a kiwi just pops up in our brain, because we have been programmed that citrus fruits are vitamin C rich. Yes, they are vitamin C rich, but they can harm us in COVID. Once again, I want to say, citrus fruits can harm us in COVID-19. So don't consume citrus fruits. Consume non-citrus fruits. They are also a good source of vitamin. Consume vegetables that are lightly cooked, not heavily or harshly cooked in a high temperature. All the pulses have good amount of vitamin C. All the vegetables have good amount of vitamin C. All the non-citrus fruits have good amount of vitamin C. But again, in COVID, we also avoid eating excess fruits and salads, because the raw food can also be a source of infection in our body, and our immunity is pretty weak and low. So we would like to avoid raw food as much as I can. So even if you want to eat some non-citrus fruits, eat it in small quantity. Don't eat any fruit that is too ripe or overripe. The more ripe the fruit is, the more softer it gets, the more chances of a bacterial or fungal infection in it. So it can harm you. Eat little fruit. Eat more amount of cooked food. Okay, so apart from that, vitamin C supplementation, we are all the doctors are prescribing it, so you can continue with the chewable tablets also. The next is vitamin E. Vitamin E is also an anti-inflammatory, antioxidative compound, same as vitamin D and omega-3. We get good amounts of vitamin E from seeds and from Pasture-raised eggs. Pasture-raised eggs are one of the best sources of vitamin E. Do consume high amount of eggs. If you are young, you can consume it with the yolk. If you are mid-age, then consume only one yolk. If you are aged, then you have to avoid yellow part of the egg. The yolk of the egg, it might not be suitable for your associated diagnostic causes. Anyways, vitamin E supplementation is also very essential. If you are not able to keep up with your dietary intake of vitamin E, you can have one capsule of vitamin E supplementation every day. It is also going to help you for a faster recovery. Next is zinc. I have been saying that vitamin C and zinc are one of the most important minerals and vitamins when it comes to COVID. Zinc is very helpful in any lung-related disorder. Zinc is also very good for your immune system, so it will help your lungs to recover faster. We can get zinc from different type of nuts and seeds, from poultry and from pulses. Apart from this, you can also always top up your diet intake with the help of a zinc supplement. Last but not the least is probiotics. Now we know that probiotics coming from lassi, buttermilk or curd are not allowed in COVID-19. So we have to switch to probiotic supplements. When we are getting a medicinal treatment for COVID, we are given antibiotics. These antibiotics are going to kill off the good bacteria in your gut. This good bacteria is responsible for digesting and breakdown of your food, and all the vitamins and minerals are associatedly absorbed in your body with the help of these microbiome, these friendly good bacteria in your gut. When you do not have good gut bacteria, you will suffer consequences. You will not absorb proper nutrition from your food. So to replenish that bacteria as soon as possible, we have to take probiotics. There is zero known evidence of any side effect caused by a probiotic supplement until unless it is adulterated. So probiotic supplements are a must. So all these vitamins and minerals, these are very essential in COVID. You can have them from natural food or you can top it up in your diet with the help of a pill. So apart from this, there is one supplement that I have not written on the board. Why? Because it is not allowed, it is not recommended, we have to avoid it. That supplement is protein powder. I have been saying you that protein is one of the very essential things for recovery in COVID, but protein powder is not advised. See, 2 out of 10 people who consume protein supplements, either it would be the sports proteins, the whey protein supplements, or the medicinal supplements, there is a chance that they can cause mucus thickening. 2 out of 10 people generally shows a sign of mucus thickening and cough and expectoration phlegm when they consume protein supplements. If you are recovering from COVID and you were hospitalized, now you are at home and you start taking a protein supplement, unfortunately, if you are among those 2 people out of 10 who might increase this mucus thickening after eating, after having these protein supplements, all your 10-15 days of recovery will go to a waste. You might have to start right from day 1. Your condition might deteriorate. So I do not taking a risk of 2 out of 10. So we have to avoid protein supplements. Instead, if you are a vegetarian, have 2 servings of Nutri soya products or soya paneer in at least 2 times in a day. If you eat non-vegetarian food, eggs are best for you. Pasture eggs are even better. Poultry, chicken, fish, every sorts of non-veg, it is good for you. Make clean food at your home. Don't buy it from the outside cooked. So I hope all these guidelines and supplements are going to help you in a better recovery. So guys, this was it. The whole playlist is complete. We have discussed the pathophysiology, all the dietary guidelines and the supplementations that we need to recover, to battle with COVID-19 infection. Still, the best viable way to defeat this coronavirus is to follow all the guidelines strictly. Use mask, use gloves, sanitize your surroundings. Don't go into social gatherings. Don't go into crowded places. Follow the strict guidelines. If you do feel any symptoms, get yourself tested right away. If you do test positive, start with these diet protocols as soon as possible. I hope these videos will be helping many people, will be helping so many people. And I need your support. You guys can share this video with the needy ones. You can share it in your social circle. You can share it in your friend circle, in your family circle. I hope you guys stay safe. But in this wave 2, honestly, nobody is actually safe. And if the conditions of our country don't improve, there might be a wave 3, there might be a wave 4, which will be even harsher than the present situation of a country. So I wish that we do not reach up to that point, and let's fight together with this COVID-19 pandemic. So even after watching these all playlists, if you do have any doubt, you can DM me, you can text me, you can put your question in the comment section below. Or if you want a proper diet plan for you or your COVID relative or friend, you guys can contact me and I will be always happy to help. So stay safe, guys. Be aware of your surroundings. Don't take unnecessary risk. Follow a healthy living diet plan so that we can get past of the situation, the worst situation that we might see in our lifetime. So I hope these videos will help. Don't forget to share. You guys stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself and your loved ones. I'll see you guys next time. Until then, you know what to do.